Greetings, all you Sodbuster enthusiasts from around the world. Welcome to Baxter's Blades. You are entering the Tiger Pit. This is a doozy. It is such a doozy of a Sodbuster. Case made a whole nother colored box. We have a blue box, and it says Crossroads on it. Now, the Crossroads is a new series of Sodbusters that's kind of a modern Sodbuster. It is held together by T6 screws. I'll take a look at it. Wood handles, micarta handles, S35V in steel. This is the black and red laminated wood. Smooth XR is Crossroads. Sodbuster. Pattern number is XR7137. And there you have it, S35VN. So you get a modern Sodbuster Jr. with a modern steel for $69.99, $70. Kind of has taken everybody by surprise. I had pre-ordered this one. They sent it off, and people are watching my short and like, they're already sold out. Well, they will come back. You can pre-order yours at Red Hill Cutlery for 2025 delivery. That's a couple months from now. Let's take a look at this one. It does not say 1 of 400. Now, this black and red laminated wood, it is only exclusive to master dealers. So not every dealer will have this version. Now you can get it in kind of a brown green wood and black micarta. Smoky Mountain Knife Works is gonna have a green micarta with orange underliners. I'm still waiting for the notification on that. I'd like to get one. That's gonna be $72, I think. So let's take a look here. You can see it's black and red laminated wood. What I do like about these wood ones is they have brass liners. Now the micarta ones, it's orange G10 or green G10. I almost got the black one with green G10, but I figured if I'm spending the money, I want to see one first. I'm going to get the 1 of 400. It said it on the website for master dealers. Unfortunately, it does not say anywhere on the Sodbuster or the box. So I guess I'll just have to remember that. Very limited. I have seen other people get these, and their XX doesn't go all the way down to the redwood. And it was Steven, Sanctified EDC, had mentioned, I love how the XX is red on mine. So maybe I got a unique one. Now, I don't have my T6, T8 drivers, but this looks like T6, T6, and I guess a T6. Look, overall fit and finish, no gaps. Maybe they can put them together a lot better than normal Soddies because they're not pinned. Let's look at the blade centering, dead down the center. The S35VN models have a cutaway instead of a nail nick, which is really nice because you can pinch it. You don't have to dig your nail in there, though you can. No half stops. The action is, it's a good pull. This is like a 7 pull, maybe an 8 pull. You can see case XX. We have 6 dots there. My lighting is poor. Hopefully I can lighten it up for 2024. I do have some oil on this. Let's get that oil off. That's factory oil. XR7137. Very cool knife. I did a short, like I said. And Sodbuster is not my favorite pattern. I have plenty of other favorite patterns, but I do have quite a few. I do prefer them in bone. Here's a bone one, persimmon orange. I do want to check the pattern number. This is 6137. And XR7137. So 37 being the pattern number. 7, I assume, is, excuse me, the wood. I could get my cheat sheet card I have somewhere around here. And I also brought out the 6.5 bone stag with the black shield that I won from Sanctified EDC's 500 subscriber giveaway. Why did I do this? I want to compare thicknesses on the handle. Now, I do not have any synthetic sodbusters. They are probably about as thick as this, maybe thicker. I had purchased one a while ago. Fit and finish was so poor on it that I returned it, and I've yet to get another. And I just really like the bone, the thinness of the bone for pocketability. This is a little bit thicker. So we'll do a 1, 2, 3, then we put the blades away so I do not cut myself. Very cool that they're offering blade steels. I'm surprised this, I don't want to talk. I was expecting this to be like $110. You know, and then it would have been like, well, I guess I'm just not going to get it. I don't need a $110 Sodbuster Jr. But this blade steel is really nice. I'll have to cut some paper here in a second. So, thickness. Yeah, it's about the same as the 6.5 Bone Stag. You can see how it swells in there a bit. And what's cool about the 6.5 Bone Stag, it's in between the bone soddies and the synthetic ones. So it's a good happy medium. And then let's compare it here to a normal bone one. You can see the thickness difference. Much slimmer in the pocket. Excuse me. I love this persimmon orange. Fit and finish on this one is absolutely perfect. Total score, one of my favorite families by Case. Absolutely love 6.5 Bone Stag. I do have another one of these, but it does not have the black shield. I'm very glad I was able to win this one. I'm going to have to do another video on my Sodbuster collection when I get another one yet in the mail. But you can see it's kind of a, they say blackwood, it's kind of gray. And you can see the lamination in there. Just a really cool knife. If you like Sodbusters, I think you'll absolutely love this. I didn't want to order a bunch of them before I got this one. I just wanted to see it first. And I wasn't going to get the wood one. I was more into the micarta. I was not into the lime green liners on the black micarta. I do like green micarta. Yes. Came fairly sharp. Uh-oh. There's no burr on there. Yeah, it's sharp. Maybe it's just paper. Yes. A sharp Sodbuster. S35VN. Now it's a little bit trickier to sharpen that steel than probably their stainless steel or their carbon steel. I'm a huge fan of their carbon steel. Let's bust out another one. One of my absolute favorites, the gray bone. You get a nice patina on it. I want to compare blade stock thickness. It looks about the same. The S35VN actually almost looks thicker, but I think that's just because the spine is more of a 90 degree and this is more rounded off. I should have a caliper to test it. But you can't go wrong with a carbon steel soddy. You know, these just seem they feel better in the hand. They feel the hand better, and you could take it apart. Now, I don't know if there's like any sort of washers in there. Let me hold it up to the light. Yeah, I don't even see any light in the back spring. I don't see any light here around the tank, so I don't know if it's washers or it's just maybe you don't need them if it's just running on that brass. I absolutely love that you can pinch that. You know, you can't stick your nail in there, but you can just pinch it. Very cool. There's been some debate on whether or not this idea has been stolen from some YouTubers and some people on Instagram. They were modding Sodbusters, basically. Making them with micarta, with colorful liners, probably putting half stops in them, probably but doing them in wood, and they showed them to Case. Well, that was your mistake. Now Case has got this, and they're running with it. And now they're going to make all the money off their ideas. They really should have compensated them, but they don't have to if there's no patent on it. And they're just Sodbuster modifiers. So, I do kind of feel sorry for them because, you know, that was kind of like their business model. They were getting soddies from people. They were modding them and sending them back, and that's probably how they were making a living. And now Case has released this. We're all just going to go out and buy these. So, yeah, I could get more into that, but I won't. Well, thank you all for joining me in the Tiger Pit. I appreciate you checking out this Crossroads 1 of 400. I don't know if you can pick them up. Like I said, 400. There's a lot of master dealers out there. They probably only got like 10 each. So yeah, that's why I picked this one up. Very nice. I think the Crossroads it is right now, it's Sodbuster. Are they going to bring other patterns into this? That's a good question. Are they going to make Trappers? Barlows? Probably not Barlows. I can't see them putting a screw right through the front bolster. And actually, Trappers have bolsters. Maybe it's just going to be Sodbusters. Because there is no bolsters. But it's interesting that they would make a whole new box. Just for the Sodbuster. Which makes me think. So there's this one, the other wood one, Black Micarta, and then the Smoky Mountains Green Micarta. There's only four out there. Why would you make a box for four? Well, I have a feeling we're going to see a lot more colors of wood, a lot more colors of Micarta, and who knows what else they'll bring. Maybe they'll do like G10. I have no idea. Now, people have done modern renditions of Trappers. You can do Trappers with screws and S35VN. I don't think they're as attractive as a traditional. I think the Sodbuster pattern, it works well. Like, I prefer pinned, but this is a modern Sodbuster. Very usable. And you could feasibly take it apart. I don't know if I'm going to try because it's put together so well. Take the blade out. You can put a half stop in that blade. I don't really need it. I can do that and then close it. A lot of people do like half stops. I know Doom Crew Outdoors puts half stops in his Trappers and other knives without taking them apart. He's an expert machinist, though. And he has the tools to probably get in there and do that. But something to be noted, like you could customize this even more. You could take the covers off and dye them even more. Very cool series. I honestly didn't think I'd like it as much as I do. I'm very impressed with the colors, the fit and finish. I may need to strop it a bit. But there's no burr on it, like most of my case knives. Now, you look at the blade grind, it's a little fine down here, and you get toward the tip, and it's like, woo, wow. Which, honestly, doesn't bother me, because most of my cutting is going to be right there with the tip. I wouldn't call that a horrible blade grind. I would call it a slicer. Thank you for joining me in the Tiger Pit. You all stay sharp, be kind, take chances, and keep your eyes open for more of these. You never know what you're gonna get. Take care.